Hi, I'm Alix Paultre with Aspen Corps, and I'm here today with Andrea Vinci from Tektronix. He's the EMEA Market Development Manager for Power Electronics. And well, we're here at a power conference, so it's perfect. Glad to have you here.
Thank you, Alix. Well, nice to meet you, really.
The pleasure is mine. Well, what I love about test and measurement is you literally have to be in front of everybody, because yes. you can't just test a system with the same caliber electronics, because if there's an error, let's say, for example, frequency. Unless you can sample at a higher frequency than the system you're testing, you're never going to learn anything. And so think about the pace right now. We're talking in the case, in this show, is wide bandgap semiconductors, but we could be talking about low power Bluetooth. There are so many spaces where the progression on the electronics is so fast, but your equipment has to be better all the time.
Absolutely, yeah. In fact, we have to always stay as a test and measurement leader ahead of our customer needs. So mm-hmm. that involves a lot of field work, to work with them, to stay with them in the lab and understand the needs and what the technology is really demanding to them.
Well, exactly. And the thing about today's engineer that I've observed is you have to be very good at systems integration today.
Yes. The
subsystem experts are all working for subsystem companies.
Yes, I agree.
But proper system integration also means you have to have a flexible test system. You know, once upon a time you can get away with a very narrow set of tools, but now you have to have a wide palette of tools. How do you address that?
Right. Yeah, our instruments, in fact, are changing this. So we have a lot of what we call the low profile version of mm-hmm. our system. So we try to remove the screen, for example, to enable these instruments to be put in a rack very easily, to create this sort of automatic test equipment and software controlled. So we are becoming very flexible also in this sense, not mm-hmm. just the usual instrument that you have on your bench.
Well, exactly, because now it's more than just the bench test. You've got to test during production now, you've got to test after production, you've got to test everywhere now, right. just to make sure that your manufacturing process is functioning, much less that the equipment is functioning the way you want it to.
Yes, absolutely, and there are cost constraints to respect, and this is why we work very hard to integrate as much as we can, so to reduce the cost per channel of our instruments, for example, of our oscilloscopes.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Now, you were saying about this series that's rack-mounted and without a screen and all. How does that give you feedback then? You just use an external monitor, or does it go to a computer or a phone?
Yes, it can go to a workstation, a computer, or you can use an external monitor. Depends on what it works best for you. Of course, the standard solution that we sell most is the standalone unit, so the one with the screen. And in fact, in that sense, we deliver a solution with the largest screen as possible.
Mm-hmm. Well, and thinking about that aspect, the connectivity aspect, what about cloud enabling? Can I remotely test? Can I be sitting in my vacation and have my friend say, hey, I got a problem, I take a quick look at it and help him? Is that possible?
Right, yes. This is something that we are working on, absolutely. This is one of the aspects that we are working from a technology point of view. There are, of course, some differences because it depends on the customer. Some customers are very protective, so they want to keep their data inside the company, so they don't want really to move to the cloud. But of course, the future will be to enable security in this sense, and we are working with the right partners for this.
Now, when it comes to security, is that a concern of yours now, or is it more of a developing concern for future cloud-enabled applications? Are you worried that much about internal security issues, or you figure the physical security of wherever they're working is satisfactory for now?
Well, that's something that depends on the customer. So each customer has their own requirements, and we need to respect them, and we need to follow what are their recommendations are.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Now, what are some of the challenges that you've seen dealing with customers? What are some of the big problems that you're hearing from the industry?
Well, definitely is the adoption of new technologies. So whenever there is an innovation that comes up, this is the most challenging thing for customers. So there is a real need of a partner rather than just an instrument suppliers. So we work together really to come to the best solution that can ease also not just their pain of introducing new technology, but also make sure that they have a partner that can help them out to understand what they do and what they have to do.
Well, that makes a lot of sense, especially in the sense of the sense I get from a lot of the distributors and equipment manufacturers is that you almost have to be just-in-time design. You know, once upon a time it was just-in-time manufacturing, the delivery, the product, everything shows up. But now it's almost that if you're a supplier or a manufacturer or OEM, you've almost got to anticipate what your customer wants or design it with them in the process just to keep them as a customer.
Yes, that's exactly my role. So we are moving to an application-oriented company. And my role in the company is exactly understand what are the needs in the future, in the short term, but also in the long term, and make sure that our product line understands perfectly what the market needs so that we can work in advance and provide the solutions that we can sell to these customers so that they can reach the time to market as soon as possible.
Now, you were mentioning this one oscilloscope family. Out of curiosity, why don't you give us the model number and tell us a little bit about that family, because you said it's also available with and without a screen.
Exactly. This is the MSO5 series, which is a revolutionary scope that we just launched this year. This is a brand new concept of scopes. It has up to 8 channels, and it has an ADC up to 12 bits. So this is a revolutionary scope, and the most important thing is that it works with all the probes that we have delivered so far, but also with the brand new probes that we specifically designed for wideband gap.
Excellent. Well, and actually you bring up a very good point. Test equipment's only as good as its probes, and these are new application spaces, new devices. You have to get new probe designs.
Yes, yes. The wideband gap space is very challenging, very, very demanding, especially in gallium nitride, because not only you need to have high voltage measurements, but you need to measure high frequencies. So these signals requires to have high bandwidth capabilities and high voltage together. So this comes to a problem, especially the common mode rejection problem. So the solution that are in the market today are not able to bring the three things together. So this is why we patented a brand new technology in this space.
Excellent. Well, that's the point. You have to keep moving forward, right?
Right.
Now, before I let you go, do you have a tip for our audience or a point about your product or company that you'd like to leave us with?
Yes, definitely. I would like to talk more about the IsoView. So this new
then
this
let's do
new
that.
Patent. Yes. So this is a completely isolated measurement system. This is galvanically isolated because this is a sort of a high voltage probe, but has the capability to measure up to 1 GHz bandwidth. And we can measure 2.5 kilovolts of differential voltage on a common mode of 60 kilovolts. So this is absolutely unique in the market at the moment, and this is basically the unique solution to probe a gallium nitride device or silicon carbide without the impact and the effect of the common mode.
Well, and that's important. I mean, it's almost a weird Heisenberg uncertainty principle kind of thing. And you test the device, you're affecting the device you're testing.
Yes.
I mean, it's not quantum mechanics, it's design engineering, right?
Yes, exactly. We always need to pick some energy out of the circuit. So we always influence this, but we try to minimize that with proper design. So this is exactly what the probe does in this sense. And so we try to reduce as much as we can the parasitic that we can add to the circuit that we are testing. And this is why we shield the tip of the probe all the way down to the point where we connect it.
Well, that also means that you've got to make sure that the probe is maintained properly, because I've seen some benches, you know. So is there some way that the machine can tell if the probe is damaged, or is there some way to do a quality control on the test probe before you use it?
Right. Right before the connection to the scope, there is a controller that reconverts the optical signal that enables the isolation into the electrical signal that the oscilloscope is capable of dealing with. And this controller has exactly a control circuit. And there is a LED that blinks, and there is something that warns you that something is wrong with your system.
So you can check your insulation, or you can check your probe connections, or make sure that you're...
Right, that you are doing things properly, and that the measurement that you see on the screen are real measurements and are not just wrong numbers.
Now, then one more thing. What about some of the trends you're seeing in manufacturing and in design? Are there any things that are coming along that we haven't seen yet, but we will be seeing very soon from you?
Well, definitely in all the markets that we are working on, like the automotive, the lighting market, motor drive control, so we have seen that the adoption of silicon carbide and gallium nitride is really moving very rapidly into that. And these components comes into different packages, so not just the TO package, but also SMD ICs, and all these have completely different requirements for the test and measurement, for the probing, for connecting to the package itself. And we are working with our customers exactly to give them the solutions that they need to work at high temperature or to hook up to the pin of the circuit the best way.
Exactly. Now, having said all of that, when you think about where the industry is going, do you see any major shifts that would cause a new requirement in test and measurement? I mean, they're doing a lot more with laminating circuitry into boards, for example, and there are things that are very difficult to access. How is there something that is that a concern or something to address downstream?
Well, there are many requirements, but for example, the fact that these, for example, these MOSFETs, these wide bandgap MOSFETs, has a very, very small RDS on resistance. So you are measuring, even if you drive high current, the resistance is very low. So the voltage that you measure is very low. So you need very high accuracy of the system. So definitely now you need a 12-bit scope. Definitely for that is very, very important because that requires you, that gives you the accuracy on the measurements that you really need.
Well, and there's no accuracy without precise feedback, right?
Right.
Thank you so much, Andrea, for
Thanks,
taking
Alex.
The time. I really appreciate it.
That was a great pleasure. Thank you very much.